Areas that were hit by water scarcity include Chibingo Upper Cell, Kaitira Cell, Chitoma Cell, Busuekera Primary School, Mpaija Primary School and Kasingo Cell.
Hoima is a city, it is a new city. We are not yet connected to national water, all the parts. It is only a few parts that are covered by national water. So we are still using this borehole water. But during this dry season, most of the boreholes are broke down and we have been getting challenges of getting safe water. So I want to thank the MP who worked with the division to ensure that these boreholes are repaired.
We are talking of boreholes in the city, but this is a temporary measure because according, you're not supposed to have boreholes in the city, in an urban area. But this one being a new city, we still have to use the repair the boreholes which we have as we plan to get pipe water from National Water and Sewage Corporation.
Sylvia Nalubanga Baliesima says Hoima Water and Sewerage Corporation have no pumps to push water to all cells that make up the city, but plans are underway to have them fixed.
An urban area, we are not supposed to encourage the boreholes because it's not in our plans. And as a city, we are supposed to be using the pipe to water. But at the moment, since we are still a baby city, we haven't reached that far of providing pipe to water to every household. So we've started by repairing the boreholes available, at least for people to be accessing clean water.
The Division Member of Parliament, Joseph Ruyonga, says lack of services such as clean water can lead to maternal death, teenage pregnancies and other diseases.
Our health indicators being poor, for example, like mothers dying in childbirth, where we have adolescent pregnancies. But sometimes you ask yourself, how did this 14-year-old girl get pregnant? If young girls are walking long distances to go and fetch water, that's why they end up meeting men and boys, and then they have pre sexual intercourse, and then they get pregnant. Sometimes, even after getting pregnant at the age of 14 or 15 or 16, they hide. And sometimes they try to abort and they end up dying.
Some of the locals whom we have talked to have revealed that they have been spending a lot on medical bills because of the contaminated water they have been using.
No sanga ubuire bayiziro ho kandi cyo makisika iri abuni nikitonya butonya nikireta mpora.
They have been walking long distance for fetching water, others buying water. So they are going to save that money and contribute to other sectors like putting on school fees.
The locals have been asked to look for ways to safeguard these water sources by creating local council one water committees.
Ekintu ekizi amaizi okuba maizi nibo bomezi kantu kusima utuhikizo muranga gwaitu hali ba kansala baitu nabo bayongerayo.
Most of the parts in the city do not have access to piped water, which forces people to end up settling for borehole water, wells and hand-dug wells near swamps. Hoima City has two divisions, east and west. In 2020, the Uganda Bureau of Statistics estimated the mid-year population of the city at 122,700. Uganda Bureau of Statistics calculated the population growth of Hoima to an average of 3.54% annually between 2014 and 2020. Report by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.